It's Sparky the Fire Dog in Cooking Safety Starts With You. Pay attention to fire prevention. At the humble abode of Kira, his fire prevention colleague, Sparky the Fire Dog, sipping a buttery Chardonnay, awaits a masterpiece of a meal being prepared in the kitchen.
So, Sparky, do you know Gary the Forest Fire Grizzly? I like his muscles.
But what's this? Head chef of this forthcoming feed is none other than Sparky's archenemy, the sinister sovereign of sirens herself, the Alarmist. She sets off alarms all over town. At least, she used to.
She used to set off all of the alarms. Then she went and got herself caught. She lives with Kira under mandatory house arrest. And now you know the basic plot.
Oh, Kira, I sure hope my apology dinner for Sparky goes perfectly to plan. I wouldn't want to burn the Barked Alaska and set off all the alarms in the house.
Well, I'm sure if you're fire-soaked while you're cooking, we have nothing to worry about.
Oh no, I've got to put my seasonal squirrel steaks on the grill. Time to fire up the hibachi.
Alarmist, you can't go outside.
Rats, no matter. I'll grill it right here in the kitchen.
Alarmist, you can't grill inside. Charcoal and propane barbecues are supposed to be used outside and away from the house.
Ah, there goes my summer menu. Oh no!
You have to be more careful, Alarmist. It's not like I'm your big sister. You've got to keep anything that can catch fire away from the stovetop. Your oven mitts, but also utensils, curtains, and tea towels.
Sorry, Kira.
Meanwhile, Sparky waits patiently for his food, like a good boy.
Read 'em and weep, boys.
It's just, I was up all night planning my grand gastronomic grotesque.
Well, you really shouldn't cook when you're overtired.
Kibble a la king, bone bourguignon, skunk and berry pie. It was so hard to choose. Not again!
Alarmist, you have to be more alert and pay attention to what you're cooking. You have to check food regularly and use a timer. And if you have to leave the kitchen, turn the stove off. Remember, my mom lives here too. Please don't burn down my family home.
In the dining room, a further fluster of familial theme as mom cracks open the family photo album.
Here we are at Carlsbad Caverns. Oh, and look, here we are at Fenway Park.
Oh,
her? Well, that's my other daughter, of course. It's amazing, really, for as fire-safe as Kira always was, my other daughter Misty's lack of fire safety awareness was alarming.
Your mother never told you what happened to your twin sister Misty, did she?
She told me enough. She told me she ran away to run a sausage cart at Carlsbad Caverns.
No, Kira. I am your sister.
No! That's not true! That's impossible! Search your feelings. You know it to be true. Oh! Misty, we can do this together. First off, don't grab the pan. You don't want to walk with a pan on fire. Next thing you want to do is smother the flames by sliding a lid over the pan and turning off the burner. And remember, keep the pan covered until it's completely cooled. Thank you, Kira. That's right, Sparky. If you have any doubts about putting out a small fire, just get out. When you leave, close the door behind you to help contain the fire. Then call 911 or your local emergency number from outside the house. Sparky, I wanted to make you the perfect apology dinner for all my years of fire safety ding-dong ditch, but I completely messed it up. Aw, thanks, Sparky. Mom, how could you not tell me that the Alarmist was actually Misty all along?
I thought you knew. Why do you think they put her in our custody?
And so, Sparky and the Alarmist's arch rivalry came to a climactic close. In fact, the Alarmist never committed an alarm-themed crime ever again. Except that one time her ankle monitor went off when she was taking out the trash.
What's that sound?
Oh, drat!
Cooking safety starts with you. Pay attention to fire prevention.